Hi, I'm Judy Umaki, and this is Video Voters Guide, a service of the League of Women Voters, a 100-year-old nonpartisan organization that believes democracy depends on informed and active participation. For more election information, be sure to visit our online site, Vote 411, before you mark your ballot. Today we have Brian Jensen, candidate for Clackamas County Sheriff, with us. Welcome, Brian.
Hi, thanks, Judy.
So tell us about your background and why you are running for county sheriff.
Well, thanks. Yeah, so I've got just over 29 years combined military and law enforcement experience. I was deployed in Operation Desert Shield and Desert Storm as a member of the 82nd Airborne Division with the United States Army back in the early 90s. After that, I was employed as a police officer for the city of North Bend down the southern Oregon coast for about 4.5 years until August of 1998, when I obtained a job up here at the Clackamas County Sheriff's Office, and I've been here ever since. I've got a pretty spectacular background in law enforcement. I've held positions in multiple divisions of our office, whether it be patrol, investigations, administration. I have experience as a supervisor line level, as well as an administrator. And I'm just really looking forward to the challenges that lie ahead. And one of the reasons I'm running for sheriff and believe that I am a viable candidate is I have the courage and the creativity to really take everybody in our office and let them be a part of our future and where we're going. The office is going to go through a change. Our current sheriff is retiring, and we're going to have a change. And I want to make sure that the change that we have is a responsible change in the positive direction.
Okay, thank you. So if elected, what would you do to improve public outreach and access to services for crime victims and family members of those experiencing a mental health crisis?
Yeah, so that's a great question. And mental health crisis, as you know, is a societal problem. Law enforcement is thrust into it, of course, because often these folks, when they do get into a mental health crisis, law enforcement is summoned. We do put our deputies through crisis intervention training. I would keep that going. In fact, I might even try to see if we could up the ante on that a little bit more to really help these folks out. We use the county's behavioral health division. Some of those folks are actually embedded in the sheriff's office. I've heard that they are starting to pull back a little bit. I think I would work closely with county mental health to see if we could actually, instead of that distance becoming greater between the sheriff's office and mental health, actually close the gap a little bit more and work closely with those folks. They're the professionals, and if they could supplement what we are doing out in patrol in that arena, I think that would benefit all of us, and especially those affected by mental health crisis.
Thank you. In your opinion, what is the most important issue for the Sheriff's Department in the coming year, and what leadership skills will you bring to deal with them?
Well, that it's changed recently, and I think the reason it has changed is because of this COVID-19 pandemic and the economic impacts that's going to have on our budget in the coming future. And I think that we're going to face a substantial budget shortfall. So I think that's going to be imperative to really figure out what services we provide that our community still expects and wants, and those that they can do without in the short term, and making those calls. So I think that's going to be the tough part. The leadership qualities that I possess and I bring to the plate, of course, I spoke to them earlier, just I have the creativity, I have the courage, and I possess a transformational leadership style that's going to allow me to, one, be collaborative. That's a key word, I know it, but I really mean that. It's really bringing in those informed stakeholders and getting their feedback on what's important, what does the community want and what do they not want. And it's also reaching out and speaking with community members face to face, eye to eye, to figure out exactly what their needs are, what their expectations are, and then making the calls accordingly.
Keeping the jail staffed and operating efficiently is part of the sheriff's duties. Are there changes that should be made to operate the jail more effectively?
I think what we need to do is we need to do a serious internal look at how we are operating at our jail. Some of the things that I have researched, and I've gone throughout the country and asked questions of different leaders of police agencies on what they do, how they do it. And one of the things that I've found that I would really like to delve into is just the cost of meals that we provide at the Clackamas County Sheriff's Office. We're pushing $400,000 a year to feed our inmates at about 91 cents a meal. And other agencies that I've talked to are substantially less, up to 20 cents less per meal per inmate. And I think we can maybe do a little bit better with that. Also, I want to look at the command structure of the jail and make sure that it has not become stagnant, which I feel that it has. And if it has, then we need to get that going again.
Okay. Have programs of alternatives to incarceration been effective? Does Clackamas County have enough resources to maintain these programs?
Well, that's a good question. And I believe they have been effective. Now, it's not effective for every single person, obviously. And do we have the resources to continue them? Well, that's what's going to be looked at with this, no doubt, budget shortfall is are they effective enough to maintain them? I think that there will be some cuts for sure in those services. We need to look at the global impact on making cuts.
It's been reported that phone and email scams are on the rise. What will you do to better deal with this problem in Clackamas County?
Yeah, you know, so I was the public information officer for 3 years, and we consistently have these scams, especially to our elderly population. And I think that what we can do a little bit better is getting the word out more. A preventive measure is what's going to do that. Now, that's not saying just be preventive on Facebook and Instagram and Twitter, but it's actually getting out and meeting with these members of our community and letting them know, because it can be a scary thing, and people don't want to. It can be embarrassing to know that you've been scammed, and I get that. I totally understand that, and it's important that we educate our public on what they can do, what they can't do, and just taking a bigger step. And what's nice about that is that doesn't cost money, that costs time. And that's something that the sheriff should have and does have, and to get out there and just educate folks.
Okay, thank you. The COVID-19 crisis, of course, has placed a huge burden on public safety, first responders, which you sort of alluded to. What more can be done to ensure that Clackamas County's law enforcement team has enough resources in the coming months?
Well, I mean, our resources are what we got. I know that we've, as far as PPE goes, that we've reached out. We've got a lot of donations coming in, and it's just to make sure that we stay up on that, to make sure that we have enough of those PPEs to keep our deputies and our folks that are working safe. And we need to really stay on top of. As far as keeping our deputies safe, it's just educating them on what to do, what not to do. It's also being out there and educating the public on what we're going to be able to respond to personally, and what we're going to be able to respond to via telephone now, just because we're trying to not only keep our deputies and our employees safe, but we're trying to keep the citizens safe as well. And we do go to calls where our deputies are being exposed, and trying to minimize that as much as possible is paramount.
So why should voters choose you over your four opponents? This is a big race, isn't it?
I would say this. I would say that I am not running out of frustration. I'm not running out of anger or anything like that. I'm running because I genuinely care about our community, and I genuinely care about our office. I am here for the long haul, in the sense that I'm not going to retire. I'm not eligible for retirement, and I really want to work with the bright men and women of our office, and I want to work with the community and make this an office that all of us can be proud of. Now, are we going to make mistakes? Of course, we're going to make mistakes. We're human beings, but we're going to learn from those mistakes, and we're going to recover from those mistakes, and we're going to move forward stronger and more effective in our services that we provide. I have a vast background in law enforcement. I have the courage to lead. I have the creativity to lead. I have the time to make the investment to make our office better. And that's what it's going to take. It's going to take time. I don't have anything outside of law enforcement that's going to pull me away from it other than my family. And I have a backing of the community. I have the backing of my family to get out there and really make a positive change. And I am honored to be a member of this office now, and I will continue to be so in the future. I want to make people proud of their sheriff, and that's what I will work tirelessly to gain the respect and the trust of our community.
Brian, thanks so much for talking with us today. Voters, don't forget to visit Vote 411 for personalized ballot information.